Now, we differ on that film, but not on our next one. Right. Our next picture is certain to arouse a great deal of controversy. It's hardcore, written and directed by Paul Schrader, the same man who wrote the ultraviolent film Taxi Driver. And like Taxi Driver, hardcore is set in a world of ugliness, the world of porno bookstores and porno films. George C. Scott plays a deeply religious man whose teenage daughter runs away from him, away from their home in Michigan. She never comes back after she visits Southern California for a religious convention. So Scott hires a private detective, played by Peter Boyle, to find her, and Boyle does, sort of. He discovers that Scott's daughter is caught up in the porno game. She's made a hardcore, rough skin flick. And in a porno shop, Boyle shows Scott the film, and it nearly destroys him. Now he's really desperate to find his daughter.
Where is she?
I don't know.
Where'd you get that film?
I bought it in a store in L.A. I gotta keep it.
Who made it?
I don't know.
What do you mean?
Wait a minute. Slow down. A film like this, 8mm film, costs $200 or $300 to make. It's sold out right in a store. Shown in peep machines. It's impossible to track down. Nobody makes it. Nobody shows it. Nobody sees it. It's like it doesn't even exist.
What's it called?
It was called Slave of Love when I bought it. Next time it's sold, it'll be called something else.
The police?
The police? You know more than the police do.
You think she's all right?
Yeah. Probably.
George C. Scott is about to enter a world that's really going to knock him for a loop. And many of the films written by Paul Schrader give us a man with traditional values coming up against the new permissiveness, which seemingly has very few values. Later in the film, Scott enlists the aid of a young prostitute, Susan Hubley, to help him find his daughter. And their different value systems clash in a beautifully written scene.
You don't understand. When I was 15, I was turning tricks in Vegas. I was taking all the older girls' regular customers. It wasn't my fault. And then they put out a contract on me. I didn't even know it was illegal.
Look, Nikki, don't go on, please. You and I, we just have very different ideas about sex and stuff.
Why, you're a sex fiend?
No.
Huh? Neither am I.
That's all you do.
It's not all... Look, how important do you think sex is?
Not very.
Although we're just alike. I mean, you think it's so unimportant that you don't even do it. I think it's so unimportant that I don't care who I do it with.
No, we're not alike. You can never understand a person like me. I'm a mystery to you. A middle-class person, Midwesterner, goes to church, believes in God, and who believes that at the end of his life he'll be redeemed. It doesn't make any sense to you. I don't know why I should have to justify myself to you. I don't care about the things you care about. I don't care what's happening in Los Angeles or New York. I don't care about the movies or TV. I don't care who's on Johnny Carson.
Well, what do you care about?
I care about my daughter.
That's a very unusual scene for a film in the 70s. Terrific there, seeing people talk about personal feelings. Usually in movies these days, we get people being hit by objects. That's terrific writing in that scene. It captures the rage, I suspect, of many people that they feel toward things new, cheap, and sexy. Hardcore is a shocking, foul-mouthed, violent, properly R-rated film, but it's a worthwhile, provocative discussion of values old and new. I liked it a lot, except for its slapdash ending. Hardcore is fascinating, I think, when it contrasts the religious world of George C. Scott with the grungy, violent world of the California porno scene.
Scott is really good in this film because he makes the character work. Here is somebody who, in the hands of another actor, could have seemed to be prudish or uptight.
Yes.
He has his values. He brings a dignity and a manliness to them so that we can really know who he is. And then when he meets the girl who is his total opposite, the other side of the sexual revolution, the young hooker, they are able to somehow transcend the things that come between them, and really make a contact as human beings.
Yeah, they really are. There's a meeting of the minds in that scene. It's a very powerful scene. I think people may be surprised by the film. We didn't show, obviously, the rough, explicit sex stuff in the movie, and people may be shocked.
Don't you
this.
Think somebody going to see a movie called Hardcore would be kind of braced before they walked in?
Well, they should be, and that's what, you know, that term is an inside porno business term, hardcore. I think they're also in the film is sort of shocking is the way the film goes after extreme religion. The film is, in terms of extreme behavior, tries to draw some links and connections that people might find kind of rough. So it's a film of real ideas.
It's another good film by Paul Schrader, who wrote Taxi Driver and who directed Blue Collar and who is really dealing with important American issues. So that's Hardcore.
We agree, however, that George C. Scott gives a riveting performance in Hardcore, a rough R-rated film about old and new values. We both say strongly yes to Hardcore.